In order to hear the sounds that you create in live, you will most likely need to use an audio interface. Let's have a look at how you set up an audio interface to work with live. Most audio interfaces don't require drivers for you to use them with your computer. However, some do. So before you connect your audio interface, please make sure that you've downloaded the latest drivers for your audio interface and install them to your computer. Also, make sure that when you connect your audio interface to your monitor speakers that they're switched off. The next step is to connect your audio interface to your computer with the cable provided. Some audio interfaces also require additional mains power. If this is the case, please make sure you've connected your power supply to your audio interface before you start live. Now my audio interface is connected, I'll start live and go to the Preferences page. Here I'll select the Audio tab. In the first section, I have three choosers. The first chooser is to select the driver type. For Mac computers, select Core Audio. If you're using a Windows computer, select ASIO. With the second chooser, I can select my audio input device. The third chooser allows me to select my audio output device. In the second section, I can select the sample rate. And in the third section, using the chooser, I can change the latency buffer size. The buffer size determines how responsive live is when processing audio. Lower latency values allow for a lower overall latency in live, but at the cost of a higher CPU load. The default is 512 samples, but I'll set it to a lower value. Now all the basic settings for an audio interface have been completed, so I'll close the preferences window. Live is now set up and ready to use, so it's a good time to switch on your monitor speakers and start making music with live.